Fire! Welcome! It's records roundup number 55. Do excuse the bloodshot eye. It looks way worse than it is. It's just what happens when you get all grit and stuff that accumulates and then a bit goes in your eye. I don't really need to go into detail, but anyway, what with me having had eye operations in the not too distant past, I do have to be a little bit careful, but I'm fine. And if you can tell by my voice, I'm also coming off a bit of a post-Christmas cold as well. I'm recording this a few days after Christmas, so still not quite the new year yet, but by the time you're watching this, it will be well into January. So plenty to show you. We'll start with a couple of mail openings on CD. That's a bit of a weird way of putting it, but you know what I mean. First one is from Amazon, and my best friend Dan, he sent me a £20 Amazon gift certificate for Christmas. Many thanks, mate. As always, I spent some of it on this and put the rest towards something very similar that I'll be showing in an upcoming records roundup. Not the next one, I don't think, because I'm hoping the next records roundup will be an artist special, which I haven't done for a while, but I've been buying a lot of albums from one particular artist. But we'll see about that come records roundup 56. Right, so let's get this open. This would have been about £14 something, just under 15. And I do already own this twice, but I'll explain why I've got it again when I get into it. Yes, they sent me the right one as well. I was a little bit worried that they'd send me the version I've already got, or one of the versions I've already got. So it's the debut album from Rammstein, Herzeleid, the 25th anniversary. Now, I've already got this 25th anniversary edition on vinyl, and I've also got the album on CD, if it comes to that. I just decided that I wanted the anniversary editions for Rammstein's first and second albums on CD that have come out in recent years. I did show the Black with Blue Spatter 2 LP 25th anniversary edition vinyl pretty much when it came out. That was, I think about 3.5 years ago now. So this CD would have come out around the same time. There's no new tracks on it. I kind of wanted this to replace the CD that I've already got. I've got an earlier version of the Herzeleid album. This is meant to be remastered. How much difference I'd be able to hear if I compared the two, and I don't know how I would compare the two anyway. Yeah, I just fancied getting this and also another anniversary edition CD that I hadn't got that isn't quite here yet. That's also from Amazon, but that's taken a few extra days. It's probably been imported somewhere from Europe. This one does have a Made in Italy sticker on the back. There's a Hype on the front there that I don't know if I'll be able to conserve. I won't get this open. There'll be a nice booklet in it, no doubt, which will be similar to the booklet, albeit a lot smaller, in the LP version that I showed 3.5 years ago. So if you do a lot of scrolling in my music collecting playlist, you'll be able to see that in whatever video it was. It wasn't a records roundup back then because I wasn't doing those. But Herzeleid 25th anniversary from my boys in Rammstein.
Ich seh dich nicht, ich erreg dich nur, ich spür dich. Ein Raum, dir das Forum erscheint, bitte richtig meilenweit.
As I say, there will be more Rammstein to show you in probably records roundup 57 it will be, but we'll see how number 56 transpires. Alright, so more CDs to show you. This is an order of three from a Discogs seller in Germany. Another big clue there. You know who I've been buying a lot of on CD recently? Well, there was some gaps to fill in their singles slash EP discography. And this seller on Discogs Marketplace, he says, this is struggling opening just a jiffy envelope here. Had a pretty good selection, including these three, for a good price that I needed to fill some gaps. Come wrapped up in some protective stuff. It's not paper. Well, I suppose technically it'd be classed as paper, but whatever. And of course, it's in strict confidence. I'll kick off with showing you the smaller item. This is the single, The Truth Inside of Me. Just getting it out of this bag here. Obviously pre-owned, quite a few years old. This, I think this might have been, it'll say on screen, so I'm guessing again, but I think 2001 or maybe 2002. But it's come just as it should inside this floppy disk style, it was called, on Discogs anyway. Case, the CD is in this little card sleeve there. There's just the CD. We've also got what I think's a sticker. Oh no, this is, there is a sticker, but no, this is actually a little booklet that's, I'm not gonna be able to read any of this without my glasses, it's so small. There you go. Quick look at that. Just interesting packaging on this. And we've got two stickers that I think are original for this. So nice that, say, this is an old and pre-owned item, that everything has been retained. So two ISC stickers there that come with the single. That was The Truth Inside of Me. And then we've also got, ah yeah, the sellers put them all in these protective adhesive outer sleeves here. We've also got Zauber Schloss, great track, and another relatively early ISC single. There you go, a little bit more sort of standard, albeit digipack packaging there. Happy that I've got that. I can go through these pretty quick. Just before I go on to the last one, how many tracks on here? 8 tracks. Forgotten how many tracks are on that. I think there's more than 2 on it though. Zauber Schloss there by ISC. And last but not least, this one here, 7 Lives. So this will be the most recent of the 3 singles. There's still other ISC CD EPs that I need. There's not many now. There's one that's on the way, hopefully, via eBay, also from Germany, unsurprisingly. And then there's 2 or 3 more that are a little bit on the expensive side. So I'm just keeping an eye out on Discogs and eBay, see if any good deals come up. But there's 7 Lives. How many tracks on here? Oh, a lot. 13, I think. Wow. And that's technically a single as well. 13 tracks on 7 Lives. So that was 3 more In Strict Confidence singles / extended EPs for the collection. Good news now is we can move on to the vinyl LPs, and I've got a nice selection to show you here. First two that I'm going to show you are ones that I've mentioned previously on the channel that I was waiting for. These are my first order from a record store, an online one that's also a bricks and mortar record store in Brighton called Resident. They've got a good reputation in the country for both in-store and online sales, and these were part of their Black Friday sale. They were both down to £13.99 each, and when I was browsing, they're really the only two in their sale that really caught my eye. I think it was the first one here that I'm going to show you. They had to order in from their supplier, and then there was some delay, or there was some damage to the original shipment, So that meant it took even longer. They did send an email out saying, if you want to pay $4.99 extra, we can send you half of your order, the other LP out, and then this one when it comes. But I thought, no, I'm not going to rush to get either of them, so they can just both come together as previously intended. So this one that took a while to get in stock, but at $13.99 I think was a good deal, is Pump by Aerosmith. I used to have this on cassette back when I was sort of pre-teen, coming into being a teenager in the early 90s. I think this is on standard black vinyl. The only other Aerosmith album I've got on vinyl is the only other one that I used to have on tape all those years ago, Permanent Vacation. And I always said if I saw Pump, but I saw it at a kind of knockdown price, I'd get that on vinyl as well. And Resident had it, so I fulfilled that promise to myself. Good album this. I used to play it quite a lot on the old Walkman when I was young. A fair few singles on it, notably Love in an Elevator, Janie's Got a Gun, which, yeah, that was a single, I think, at least in America anyway. I mean, it's all pretty familiar to me, because even though it's probably been a good 25 years since I've heard the album, it was one that I played a lot, particularly in the early 90s. So yeah, happy to have Pump by Aerosmith back in the collection after all these years. And the other pickup, the Black Friday reduction from Resident in Brighton, was another Who picture disc. And this one's a pretty new release as well. Who's Next, the 50th anniversary picture disc. So this has been re-released pretty recently in a load of different formats. There's a couple of box sets. There's obviously the album remastered at half speed. I think there's another reissue of the album that isn't half speed. And then there's this picture disc as well. I picked up The Who's most recent album, Who, on picture disc for a good price from Polydor Music that I showed you in what I think will be the previous Records Roundup. And then when I saw this, and it is an album that gets very good ratings in the vinyl community. I know a couple of people who particularly like Who's Next, and I'm a bit of a sucker for a picture disc at the best of times. So at $13.99, I thought that's a pretty good deal, especially as it's quite a new release as well. It's not been out too long. Obviously, the original album was early 70s. Get this open briefly, because I do want to have a closer look at the disc itself. I'm assuming the back of the disc is going to resemble the back of the sleeve, but I don't suppose I'll know that for certain until I get it out. Ooh. I enjoyed Who, the most recent 2019 album from The Who. They've become a little bit of a revelation for me, The Who, really, in that I've taken a punt on all their albums, really, so far, that I've got. Face Dancers, I got that really cheap in a sale. Same for Who, same for this. And Face Dancers and Who, I thought were really good. Much better than I expected them to be. Yeah, they're never going to be my very favourite band ever, but so far so good, and, you know, this is meant to be one of their absolute classics. So, Who's Next? And yes, I can see here, and I'll show you in a sec, the back of the disc, or side B of the disc, I should say, resembles the back of the album sleeve. So, yeah, just a nice picture disc to own as part of the Who's Next 50th anniversary campaign. And it goes in my very small still, but rather surprisingly good to me, Who collection. The picture disc, LP, 50th anniversary, Who's Next? I'm Next, I move on to a pickup from Vinyl Tap. Now, I actually bought two albums from Vinyl Tap in this order, but I'm only going to show you one today, because the other one I'll show you in the hopefully artist special for Records Roundup 56 soon. I'm just waiting for one more album to come in the post relating to that. But this one had to be bought, really, and I think it was $12.99 at Vinyl Tap, brand new. Although I did extend my rules, or change my rules to extend the price limit, I should say, for collecting this group. This one ultimately fell way short of the £18, formerly £15 limit at $12.99. This is, of course, The Madness by The Madness. I mean, it's basically, I think, was it four or five members of Madness? Four, I think. Getting back together in 1988, it would have been. I think they were going to have a completely different name, and then they did a fan survey of some kind, asking what they should be called, and the winner of the poll was The Madness, for some strange reason. So I've not heard anything on here. I think the one single, I Pronounce You, I've heard a little bit of it because I found a clip that hopefully I'll be able to play in a little while. I've not even heard that at the time because it didn't do anything. It didn't get into the top 40 here in the UK. I think this is meant to be quite a bit different from sort of standard Madness. Yep, this just completes the Madness in the 80s studio album collection, actually. At $12.99, brand new, black vinyl, I'm not going to get it open. Had to have it, really. So thank you to Vinyl Tap for The Madness. But we're going to stick with Madness and the drop the. And this is one that I have broken my rules here, but I had to have it. It's pretty new. It's their first number one album, and this is a particularly unique edition. Well, not dead unique, but unique to only 300 copies. Anyway, it is their most recent studio album, Theatre of the Absurd presents C'est La Vie. And this is from, as are the last two albums to show you in this video as well, from Asai Records in Glasgow. I think they've got a few branches dotted around Scotland, but their main one is in Glasgow. So this is the Asai Records OB edition. And they do this for a fair amount of artists, actually. They've got some sort of agreement where they can add an OB strip to an album. It's the same clear vinyl edition that you could pick up most places. But Asai Records, they have a special OB edition section where they can number a certain amount, in this case 300. Mine is number 155. I wanted to hear this. It was $30.99, but I don't think that's bad because it's two LPs, so in a way it's kind of still within my own rules of fashion, because each disc would be under £18 each. Bit of a liberal interpretation of my own rules there, but hey, they're my own rules, I'm allowed to break them, I suppose, or at least make a bollocks of trying to explain why I bought this. I've not heard anything on here. Nick's vinyl buddy, who hopes watching, hi Nick, is a massive Madness fan. He likes this, so that's a good enough recommendation for me when the vinyl community's two-tone king gives it the thumbs up. And it got to number one as well, deservedly so. I think even if I end up thinking this isn't one of their best albums, you know, a group like Madness, who've achieved so much and have been so ubiquitous on the British music scene for almost 50 years now, you know, really, they should have had a number one album many years ago, but they finally got one in 2023 with Theatre of the Absurd presents C'est La Vie. Invitations have been sent, I'm simply to write good crime. Congratulations, phoning from a long lost friend. For the big occasion, regretting that he can't attend. And as family tradition is busy making up your mind. Girl at the standing draped in his holy shroud. God's representative, almost to attend. I now. I haven't shown you the album. It's clear vinyl, but just to keep this video moving along, and also what with it having an OB strip and it's got an adhesive outer sleeve as well, I didn't want to start mucking up in case I wasn't able to make everything neat again standing here doing this video. But I will show you the vinyl and also something else that comes within it for this penultimate pickup from Asai Records. Because it's a dual format set, it's the debut album from Bananarama, Deep Sea Skiving. So this is on blue vinyl, and it also contains the CD, which I think has more tracks on it than the LP, because it's got some extended versions of stuff on as well. So that'd be nice to listen to both of those. Bit of an impulsive purchase, but I wanted to get Madness, Celebi, and the final album here to show you. And then I was, I think, something like £4 or £5 away from free postage. So I thought, well, can I find anything in Asai's cheap sections just to get me over that £50 mark, and then delivery's free? And I'd been noticing this for a while. It was £8.99. And although I'm not a Bananarama collector, I do like some of their 80s singles, probably some of their 90s ones as well, if it comes to that. And for under a tenner, coloured vinyl, CD included as well, I thought, you know what, bit impulsive, but let's get Deep Sea Skiving. So this was Bananarama's first studio album. There was certainly of that sort of post-punk, new wavy sort of vein in their very early days. Struggling to get this open for some reason. Happens to me occasionally, this, where I end up buying a record and even cutting the cellophane is an absolute pig with a particularly sharp knife. Aren't we in here yet? Surely I've done it now. No, I haven't. You know what? Because I don't want to actually damage the sleeve, I'm just going to tear off the cellophane. There is a hype sticker there, but if I'm careful, I think I should be able to conserve it. Carefully does it. What a noise. There we go. That's how hype stickers should be anyway. They should be on the sleeve itself, like they used to be back in the day. Right, after all that, I would have edited lots of that out so that you weren't just watching me for 5 minutes struggling. But there's your inner. Find the CD that, it just comes in a plain plastic envelope there. But yeah, that's got some extended versions on, some 12-inch mixes, I suppose there would be, of, I think, probably predominantly the singles. And there's your rather predictably blue to represent the deep sea, but very nice nonetheless. Vinyl record there. I'm looking forward to listening to this. It wasn't a purchase that I particularly expected to make, but it had been in one of Asai's really quite impressive, to be honest, reduced sections for ages now. And I just thought, just to get my order over the threshold for free postage, their debut album, Bananarama's Deep Sea Skiving, on CD and blue LP, no less. And finally, we'll finish off with a third pickup of three from Asai in Glasgow. And it's a group who I did threaten, if I saw their albums that I needed on vinyl, particularly their 90s, although I've got, I think, that only one from the 90s on mini disc, and then another one on mini disc from early 2000s. But if I saw any of their other albums going at a good price, then I would pick them up, because I do like this group. It's Embrace, and their, I think, fifth album, This New Day. So this was $14.99. I just did a search for Embrace and then this came up. Ironically enough, it was Asai Records where I got another Embrace album from not too long ago, and that did have a massive reduction. That was down in their $5.99 section. And I'm sure I'm going to enjoy this. It's got Nature's Law on it, which is not only my favourite Embrace single, but it's one of my favourite singles by anyone of all time. Such a beautiful track, Nature's Law. Should have been a much bigger hit than it was, really. I think it got top 10, or certainly top 20, but I don't know. For me, should have been massive, that, but I suppose in a way I'm glad it wasn't, because it would have probably been too ubiquitous now. You know, a bit like kind of Chasing Cars by Snow Patrol, which I think, you know, everyone thought was a good song when it first came out, but after it was on the chart for like a year, and then you heard it all the time on TV and in Gavin and Stacey and stuff like that, you began to think, oh no, I've heard this too many times. But anyway, on black vinyl, glad I found this for such a good price. I think after this album, Embrace split up for a few years or went on hiatus, and then they've come back in more recent times with, I think, another two or three studio albums that I may try and pick up at some point. It was the earlier era, or the 90s 2000s era Embrace I was most wanting, and there is one more album, the one that came before this, that I'm missing, but that one doesn't seem to be anywhere particularly cheap at the moment. I'll keep a lookout, but glad to have This New Day by the lads in Embrace. Now everything's got meaning, the meanings bring me down. I'm watching as a screening of my life plays out. Every day I fight these feelings. Be you sick, I will hide the real thing. You can run all your life, call mine, I will change. You should never fight your feelings. When your very bones believe them, you should never fight your feelings. You have to follow nature's law. And that was Records Roundup 55. Thank you all for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. Special thanks go, as always, to my wonderful subscribers and generous patrons. Please see my Patreon link and my Facebook group link in the description text box down below, or wherever it may be on your device. I'm going to go now. Plenty to listen to, there always is. Still got a backlog, as of the time of me recording, of stuff that I've bought before Christmas. You'll have seen videos of unboxings and all the records roundups over this sort of post-Christmas, early New Year period. So you know that I've got a load still left to listen to, but it's always good to have music on the go. And rather than stand here any longer and waffle on about it, I shall go now and just ask that you will join me again next time for my next records roundup and music collecting video. Cheers, everyone. See ya!